Hi, I am Pat. I would like to speak to you briefly about the pink slime in our meats. Basically, which of course boils down to the American dollar greed. How much money can we make, and who cares if people's health is affected as long as we can make money? Do you know 70% of the supermarkets use beef for hamburger, which contains pink slime? And only two main chains have admitted it so far. You know, it's all about money. The way pink slime is made, there's bits of meat left over from other cuts. There's leftover cuts, pieces of scrap, garbage they used to use for like dog food and cat food. It was garbage. But of course, people found, here's a new way to make money. Let's turn this garbage into actual food for people. Let's feed the humans this garbage and we're going to make more money. The grocery stores will make more money. We all make more money. Who cares about their health? So now you got this scrap meat, this garbage, which is turned into food for humans. It's heated and then spun, which removes the fat. That's magic. It removes the fat. And then they, of course, add ammonia to it. And then they can suddenly use this, they can use this into for adding into ground beef. It's very lean because they've removed the fat, and it's very inexpensive because, of course, it's garbage. It's waste. And, it's, of course, feed the waste to the human beings. We're going to make more money that way. Producers then mix it into an inferior quality, a fattier product, which normally would not be suitable. But this way they can get the 80% lean rating, and so they can sell this lean ground beef. And of course, Janet Riley from the American Meat Institute, now this bloodsucker, you can trust her. She'd sell her soul for a dollar probably. But you can trust this bloodsucker, Janet Riley, who works for the American meat industry, because she says, technically, of course, it is beef. It's a beef product. This is beef, so you don't have to specially label it, which is good news for the meat industry because that means money, more money. They're turning garbage into meat, more profit. Let's say 20% of the meat was garbage. Suddenly this 20% is turned into cash. That's extra profit that would normally never be seen. So the grocery stores love it. The meat industry loves it, because they're making extra money selling us garbage. It says they may look the same, but they're composed of different meats. One could be unadulterated ground beef made from cuts of meat containing 20% fat. The other could be a much poorer quality beef or meat, which is made much leaner by using this pink slime. So you're getting a double whammy. You're getting a much fattier, much poorer quality of meat. And then you're getting the pink slime, which is chemically treated with ammonia. So you're getting a double whammy. And then you can sell it as all natural, because technically it is natural. Or you can buy the more expensive organic beef, $5.99 a pound, versus $3.09 a pound. Who can afford the $5.99 a pound nowadays? So of course the human beings, the human guinea pigs, as they called us years ago in the war, the human cattle, we sacrifice our health so the meat industries can make more money, and the USDA says it's okay. Of course, until there's a public outcry, thanks to the public outcry, the schools now have a choice to serve our children pink slime meat or serve them the healthier, if there is such a thing as healthy beef, the healthier, truly leaner brown ground beef, because it is actually leaner, because it's not made up, make-believe leaner, because of the pink slime additive. Can you tell the difference by looking? Unfortunately not. Somebody did a taste test comparing a lean as opposed to pink slime. The lean, of course, when you fry it, It did leave more grease in the pan because it wasn't, you know, it was actually ground beef, which is, of course, going to be fattier. But when they did the pink slime beef, of course, there was less grease in the pan because, again, you got this garbage, this trash that was chemically treated, added to your meat. So there will be less fat. But when you taste them side by side, the pink slime meat did have more gristle and it had a different texture. It definitely did not taste nearly as good. So if you do compare the ground beef, they won't taste as good. But you add all the condiments and all the salt and pepper, and you can't probably tell the difference because our tastes are getting so perverted nowadays anyway. We're so used to chemicals and spices and herbs added to our foods. It's hard to tell the difference. It's a shame, but it's true. So all we can do as Americans is speak up to the USDA, even go as far as contact your senators and congressmen, tell them this has got to stop. We are sick of being guinea pigs and eating this garbage so the industries can make more money. Speak up right to the USDA, right to the government, say, hey, no more human guinea pigs. You can write to the meat industry, but you think they give a rip about what we say? They only care when they get caught. I'll try and put a link at the bottom also for the USDA so you can email them. At least that's a starting point. Our voices need to be heard. The more that speak up, the better the results. So please, please, please speak up. Tell the USDA you do not want pink slime food. You want it labeled so you have a choice. Just like the bovine years ago in the milk. Until the people spoke up, nothing happened. When people speak up, things begin to happen. Of course, now they've pretty much stopped labeling bovine free again because people forgot about it, but at least it helps to speak up. Let yourself be heard. Thank you for watching.